If you guys are looking for fast, cheap, reliable coins for your college football 25 team, check out my coin sponsors at MMOXP and use discount code MONEYSHOT for 5% off your order. Link in the description below.
The champ is here!
Welcome back, Money Team. This is Matt MoneyShot, sniffing out the college cheese as always. Got a weird one for you today as we have an update and we have more information about a future update that will be coming, but there's no patch notes for today's update, so I had to do some detective work going through a series of tweets or a series of X posts that College Football Direct put out, but I'm going to decipher all that for you guys in a minute. But before I do, if you guys want me to continue to do videos like this, update videos as they come out, please make sure to be a subscriber, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. Now, last night there was a tweet from the CFB Direct account saying, hey, College Football 25 fans, title update server maintenance will begin tomorrow, Thursday, August 8th at 6 a.m., which is a typical post that they put out. It says, during this time, all online modes, T-Builder will be unavailable. Please be sure to complete all online games before maintenance begins. This is typical for what they put out every single time they're going to do something the following day, because they want to make people aware that there may be issues if they play the game. It says, we will provide an update when the maintenance is complete. Now, that's the most important part. Typically, when it says we will provide an update when the maintenance is complete, that's typically what they mean is they're going to put out patch notes. Now, fast forward to today, and the only real patch notes we got was a short blurb in a tweet that said, hey, players, an update is available for College Football 25 today. We've tackled the kick meter visual issue and made general stability improvements. Now, as far as the kick meter issue, visual issue, I think they're talking about when you're doing an onside kick. There was a glitch earlier in the year where you could hit, you could basically do an onside kick where you push this meter all the way to the right and then hit low kick, or I don't even know, it might have been high kick, one of the two, but either way, the actual visual of the kick meter going down like that wasn't working. You would hit that button and it wouldn't move. It would still go to normal. So it made people think that they basically patched onside kicks. That's the only real difference I noticed now, is now that this actual kick meter goes down. So it's potentially true that onside kicking is back, although once again, it's on kick and hold, and you can see, so that the onside kick might work again. They still haven't fixed the tap and tap or the tap and hold. As you can see there, it's still defaulted to tap and hold, which is why that didn't work out very well. But that's all they reported in that particular tweet, with the exception of this next detail here, which is kind of important because they tell you when the next title update is going to happen. We all thought, based on the fact that they said in the original tweet that that title update was going to come today, but I guess whatever they were trying to do didn't work out, and now they pushed it off 2 weeks, because it does say here, we're cooking up a campus huddle for a future update, but until then, enjoy the next 2 weekends of games. Now, that basically lets you know that you're going to have to wait 2 weeks for the next update. But whatever they did today, maybe they did something to set that update up. It's really hard to say. But at least we know that at least, you know, 2 weeks from now, that we will have a title update, an actual title update for College Football 25. Now, that doesn't end the tweets that they had today, though, because there were some more confusing tweets. There's another one here. It says, we'll be doing some server maintenance shortly to address some issues with Dynasty. Server maintenance will begin at 11:15 a.m. Eastern time. During this time, all online modes, blah, 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 they'll be off once again. So please complete that prior to maintenance. It says, please be sure to complete all online games before maintenance begins. Now, this one's weird because it's titled August 9th, which is tomorrow. It says, we'll let you know when this maintenance has been completed. Thank you. Which I don't understand how it's dated for a future date. But there's also another tweet here, which is dated today, that says, Dynasty update. We are aware of players experiencing issues with Dynasty mode, including the following. When using schemes and playbooks to change your coach playbook / scheme, your player archetype and overalls change based on the scheme. Now, this is something that I was pretty sure they said that they patched a long time ago. Because I mean, obviously it's been a recurring issue, but this is something that was in a previous patch that they said that they had fixed, or they at least gave a workaround, where they're probably gonna do the same thing here in a minute. So this is something, I don't know if last time that they said that they patched it was lip service, but these are the Dynasty issues that I guess they're looking into as we once again have a update coming in 2 weeks. Maybe this will be a part of that. Maybe they fix that today. It's really hard to say. I couldn't test all these things. It says another thing was, incoming freshmen are not appearing in the position changes screen during the off season. And then there's also annual non-conference games are not rotating, which is also a well-known issue that a lot of people have been dealing with. And then they give you a workaround like I thought they would. It says, while the team investigates and works towards a resolution for these issues, we recommend players do not use the scheme slash playbook screen, which is going to be this one here, which is something that I remember. I made a video about this. I made a specific video where they said that they patched this specific issue because this was the cover right here, but the thumbnail. But either way, it says, instead of using this, use the edit coach screen to change your playbooks. The funny thing was, too, I remember that they did patch this because it wasn't retroactive. And I think that this is, I think I'm still in the same, actually, no, I'm pretty sure I restarted my season. But either way, yeah, I do remember they did patch this. It just wasn't retroactive because I had to restart my franchise to fix it. And I'm not even sure if I did that, if I'm being honest. I have to go to my depth chart here to figure that out. Where people are still, yeah, I never reset it. You can see here, this is still the same issue where everybody is, all my quarterbacks are field generals because I changed, I think, the Alabama's playbook. All my running backs are elusive backs, even though obviously that's not all their forte. You know, so I guess this is obviously a still issue, which I was not aware of that. You can see all my receivers are deep threats, even though they're not all deep threats. So that's still an issue that they're having, but like I said, we're at least getting communication that they're working on fixing that. You just might have to wait 2 weeks for this patch to be fixed. But there's still a lot of stuff to be patched here. This guy here put up, I'm just going to put his comment on, this was on EA's forum. I'm just going to put his comment up because it was pretty on point. And he names just about every single thing I could think of that still needs to be fixed in this game. So I'm just going to read it from the top here. It says, notice no alterations to sock change and long sleeve primarily or secondary color options for most teams. No new uniform options. No patches for custom conference uniform and field logo anomalies. Conference scheduling errors continue to permeate every new dynasty save. And team poll ranking, simming results, and bowl game qualifications have not changed in months. Conducting dynasty career modes save with these problems is intolerable for me personally, has prevented me from even playing the game since September 19th. So I don't know if you guys are having similar issues. I know me personally, the thing that probably bothers me the most is just inability to save stuff like, I mean, he mentioned here how there's, you know, you can't even change uniforms in online Road to College Football Playoffs, which is crazy, let alone playbooks. Other than that, I saw another good comment here where they said that the rosters aren't updated properly, which is another small thing that I think really needs to be fixed. As simple stuff like the rosters for Dynasty and Road to College Football Playoffs don't match. If you play both games, a lot of times you'll notice that there's like a receiver missing. Like when I use BYU, I'm pretty sure in Dynasty or in Play Now, there's two 96 speed receivers. But when I go into the game, there's only one. It happens like that on a couple of different rosters that I've noticed. And it's pretty consistent throughout the game. So they got to make it to the point where if you're going to update the rosters, you're updating it for both games. But EA did just update the ratings of a lot of their college players. And I made a video about that. So if you guys want to check that out, I'll have that popping up on screen. And other than that, until next time, thanks for watching, man. Mush it out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below.